One TV Special 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 Report Special Report.
Having 11 members present, the chair declares a quorum. May I request the assistant minority floor majority floor leader to please conduct the proceedings.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Number four, this morning we don't have any visitors, we'll proceed to number five, approval of the agenda for today's meeting. This morning, Madam Chair, we don't have insertion, so I move for the approval of agenda of today's meeting, Madam Chair.
There's a motion from the Assistant Majority Floor Leader for the approval of our agenda for today. Motion approved.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We'll proceed to number six, approval of the minutes of the previous sessions. Regular sessions of September 5 and 13 and a special session of September 6 of 2022. Is there any comments or remarks concerning these two regular sessions and the minutes of these two regular sessions and one special sessions? If there's any comments, Madam Chair, since each one of us has a copy of this regular session, special session, I move alpha a motion for the approval of the minutes of the previous sessions, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Honorable Assistant Majority Floor Leader Lau. It has been manifested by Honorable Lau that considering that everybody has been furnished with a copy of our previous minutes, the special and the regular session, so he manifested, is there any comments, remarks to be considered? The motion of Honorable Lau for each approval is hereby approved.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We'll proceed to number seven. Proposed letter A, proposed ordinance, none. Letter B, proposed resolution, none. We'll proceed to letter C, petition or request for first reading. Number one, letter dated September 28th of 2022 from the Honorable City Mayor in the Waminal requesting for resolution approving the conduct of DepEd Osamis monthly pahina activity for school year 2022 in Osamis City. Madam Chair, I refer this matter to the Chair Committee of Education, Madam Cecil Co.
The Honorable Cecil Co is now
for appropriate action, Madam Chair.
The Honorable Cecil Co is now recognized by the Chair.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and thank you, Assistant Majority Floor Leader. So, I move to pass a resolution on first reading approving the request for the conduct of DepEd Osamis monthly pahina activity for school year 2022 in Osamis City for first reading again with reservations.
For first reading with reservation, the Honorable Co. Passing this item number one. Motion approved.
Thank you again, Madam Chair. So in strengthening City Ordinance number 1240-2022 requiring all national government agencies to seek prior consultation and approval from the local government of Osamis before the conduct of any national activity, project, or program in the city. And that DepEd Osamis has sent the LGU of Osamis, Osamis City a letter, consultative letter to the city mayor for the conduct of their monthly pahina schedule for the whole school year of 2022 And finally, for the efficient delivery of public service, and especially to the school learners of Osami City, I move to pass this resolution on second and final reading, waiving the internal rules.
Manifested by the Honorable Call, this letter dated September 28, 2022, from the Honorable City Mayor requesting for a resolution approving the conduct of DepEd Exami's monthly Pahina activity for the school year 2022 in Exami City. It was well justified by the Honorable Call that this be passed on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules. Is there any comment? Remarks? Hearing none. Motion approved on the second and final reading.
May I proceed, Madam Chair? Thank you, Madam Chair. We'll proceed to number two under letter C, 2022 Supplemental Budget number 01 of Barangay Balintawak in the amount of 285,000. Madam Chair, I would refer this matter to the Chair of the Barangay Affair, Councilor John Doctor, for appropriate action, Madam Chair.
Honorable John Doctor, you are now recognized by the Chair for the appropriate motion.
Thank you, Acting Majority Floor Leader. Thank you, Honorable Chair. With regards to the request for approval of the supplemental budget, Honorable Chair, of Barangay Balintawak in the amount of 285,000. I move, Honorable Chair, for first reading with reservations, Honorable Chair.
Move by the Honorable John Doctor to pass this 2022 Supplemental Budget 01 for first reading with reservation. Motion approved.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. Considering its immediate implementation and considering all the documents required is being submitted, and of course this request is duly endorsed by our Acting City Budget Officer, Honorable Chair. I so move, Honorable Chair, for second and final reading, waiving the internal rules regarding the supplemental budget of Barangay Balintawak in the amount of 285,000, Honorable Chair.
Thank you. Considering the urgency for the approval of this 2022 Supplemental Budget number 01, of Barangay Balintawak, move by the Honorable John Doctor to pass this on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules. Any comment, remarks? Hearing none, motion approved on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules.
May I proceed, Madam Chair? Thank you, Madam Chair. Under letter C, number 3, 2022 Supplemental Budget number 01 of Barangay Mentoring in the amount of 82,000. I would again refer this matter, Madam Chair, to the Chair of Barangay Affair, Councilor John Doctor, for disposal, Madam Chair.
Honorable John Doctor, you are now recognized by the Chair for the appropriate motion.
Thank you again, Honorable Chair and Acting Majority Floor Leader. The Barangay Mentoring is also requesting for its approval their supplemental budget, Honorable Chair, in the amount of 82,000. I just move this, Honorable Chair, for first reading, Honorable Chair, since there are necessary clarification on this matter, Honorable Chair, just for first reading only, Honorable Chair.
For first reading only? The Honorable John Doctor is passing this 2022 Supplemental Budget number 01 of Barangay Mentoring in the amount of 82,000. Motion approved on the first reading, as being manifested by the Honorable Doctor. Motion approved. Any comment? Remarks? Hearing none. Motion approved on the first reading, and this be referred to the appropriate committee.
Madam Chair, may I proceed? Thank you, Madam Chair. We'll proceed to letter D, messages and communications. Number one, executive order number 22-HFOJ-12, dated the 28th of September 2022, realigning items in the appropriations under the capital outlay of the City Accounting Office in the amount of 100,000. Madam Chair, I move for a joint resolution concurring and adopting this executive order, Madam Chair, 22-HFOJ-2, dated September 22, for first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
For first reading with reservation, the Honorable Assistant Majority Floor Leader is moving this to concur and adopt this executive order number 22-HFOJ-12. Motion approved on the first reading with reservation.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Concerning the urgency of this executive order number 22-SF0J-12 dated 28th of September 2022, I move for the approval in second and final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
Due to the urgency of this executive order number 22-HFOJ-12, the Honorable Assistant Majority Floor Leader is moving this to concur and adopt this executive order, realigning items in the appropriations under the capital outlay of the City Accountant's Office in the amount of 100,000. Is there any remarks, comment? Hearing none, motion approved on the second and final reading for its adoption and concurrence.
May I proceed, Madam Chair? Thank you, Madam Chair. We'll proceed to letter number two. Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-12, dated 28th of September 2022, realigning items and the appropriation under 2022 maintenance and other operating expenses budget of the senior citizens in the amount of 200,000. Madam Chair, I move for a joint resolution to concur and adopt this executive order number 22-HFOJ-14, dated 28 September 2022, for the first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
For first reading with reservation, the Assistant Majority Floor Leader is passing this executive order number 22-HFOJ-14. Motion approved on the first reading with reservation.
Madam Chair, concerning the urgency of this executive order number 22-HFOJ-14, dated 28 December 2022, I move for the passing in the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
Due to the urgency of this executive order number 22-HFOJ-14, dated 28 September 2022, realigning items in the appropriations under the 2022 maintenance and other operating expenses budget of the senior citizens in the amount of 200,000, manifested by the Assistant Majority Floor Leader to concur and adopt this executive order as being requested by the Honorable City Mayor. Any comment, remarks? Hearing none, motion approved on the second and final reading.
May I proceed, Madam Chair? Thank you, Madam Chair. We proceed to number three. Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-15, dated 28 September 2022, realigning items and the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Accountant's Office and the amount of 40,000. Madam Chair, I move a joint resolution for the approval for the, to concur and adopt Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-15, dated 28 September 2022 to pass this resolution in the first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
There is a motion from the Honorable Assistant Majority Floor Leader to pass this on the first reading with reservation, this Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-15. Moved by the Honorable Assistant Majority Floor Leader that this be concurred and be adopted. Motion approved on the first reading with reservation.
Madam Chair, thank you. I move for the passing of the resolution for Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-15 dated 20 September 2022 for the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
Due to the urgency of this Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-15 that is dated 28 September 2022, realigning items in the appropriations under the maintenance and other operating expenses in the City Accountant's Office in the amount of 40,000. Move with the Assistant Majority Floor Leader to pass this on the
second and final reading,
waiving the internal rules. Is there a comment? Remarks? Hearing none, motion approved on the second and final reading.
Thank you, Madam Chair. May I proceed to 3-A. A letter dated September 26 of 2022 from Attorney Sam Norman G. Fuentes, a City Administrator, requesting the OIC Centro to have prior consultation with the Honorable City Mayor and approval of the Sangguniang Panglungsod on their desired presentation activity in connection with the legitimation of the Clarín Integrated Watershed Shed Management Plan in compliance with Ordinance Number 12-1240-2022, Madam Chair. I move for a joint resolution to concur and adopt this letter dated September 12, 2022. I would like to make some correction, Madam Chair. Instead of making a resolution, just this letter just be noted, duly noted, and the City Council, Madam Chair. I'm sorry about the earlier statement, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Honorable Lau. Manifested by the Assistant Majority Floor Leader, Honorable Lau, that this letter, dated September 26, 2022, from Attorney Sam Norman G. Fuentes, our City Administrator, be just duly noted. Any comment? Remarks? Motion approved.
Thank you, Madam Chair. May I proceed to number four. Executive Order Number 20-HFOG-16, dated 28 September of 2022, realigning items and the appropriation under maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Budget Office and the amount of 70,000. Madam Chair, I move for a joint resolution approving to concur and adopt Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-16 dated 28 of September 2022 to pass this on the first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
Passing this on the first reading with reservation, this Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-16, passing that on the first reading with reservation.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Concerning the urgency of this amount, Madam Chair, I move for the passing of this resolution for the second final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
Passing this for second and final reading, this Executive Order Number 22-HFOG-16 dated 28 September 2022 that is realigning items in the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Budget Office in the amount of 70,000. Moved by the Assistant Majority Floor Leader to pass this on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules. Is there any comment? Remarks? Hearing none. Motion approved on the second and final reading.
Madam Chair, may I proceed to number 5? Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-17, dated the 28th of September 2022, realigning items and the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the city, human resource and management office in the amount of 23,474.90 pesos, Madam Chair. I move for a joint resolution concurring and adopting this executive order number 22-HFOJ-17 dated 28 September 22 to pass this into first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
Passing this on the first reading with reservations to concur and adopt this executive order number 22-HFOJ-17. Motion approved on the first reading with reservations.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Concerning this amount is urgently needed by the City Human Resource and Management Office, I move to pass this resolution for the second final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
Due to the urgency of this executive order number 22-HFOJ-17 dated September 28, realigning items in the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Human Resource and Management Office in the amount of 23,474.90 centavos. Move with the Assistant Majority Floor Leader to pass this approval for the concurrence of this Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-17 due to its urgency. Motion approved on the second and final reading.
Madam Chair, may I proceed to number 6? Under number 6, Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-18, dated 28th of September 2022, realigning items and the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Mayor's Office in the amount of 4 million. Madam Chair, I move for a joint resolution concurring and adopting Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-18 dated 28th of September 2022 to pass this in the first reading with reservation, Madam Chair.
Passing this on first reading with reservations, this Executive Order number 22-HFOJ-18. Passing this on the first reading with reservations.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Concerning that this amount is urgently needed by the City Mayor's Office for the maintenance and other operating expenses, I move for the passing of this resolution for the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules, Madam Chair.
It has been moved with the Assistant Majority Floor Leader to pass this on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules, concurring and adopting this executive order number 22-HFOJ-18, dated 28 September 2022, realigning items in the appropriation under the maintenance and other operating expenses of the City Mayor's Office in the amount of 4 million. Is there any comment? Remarks? Hearing none. Motion approved on the second and final reading, waiving the internal rules.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I proceed to number 8, committee reports submitted none. Number 9, calendar of business, letter A, unfinished business, none. Letter B, business for the day for second reading, none. Letter C, unassigned business, none. We'll proceed to number 10, business for third reading, none. 11, PCL matters, none. We'll proceed to number 12, SK matters. I would refer this matter to the chair of the SK matters, Madam Chair.
For his
Councilor Sibilio, for his appropriate action, Madam Chair.
For SK matters, may we hear from Honorable Erwin Ochovillo.
Thank you, Mr. Assistant Majority Floor Leader, Honorable Presiding Officer. For SK matters, Madam Chair, there is none as of the moment.
Thank you.
May I proceed, Madam Chair? Under number 13, ABC matters, I would refer this matter to the Barangay Affairs. Councilor Jan Doctor for his action, Madam Chair.
Honorable Jan Doctor, you are now recognized by the Chair for ABC matters.
Thank you, Acting Majority Floor Leader. Thank you, Honorable Chair. For ABC matters, Honorable Chair, just to inform this August body that our target date instead of September 30 is being extended up to October 8 to reach the 80% COVID first booster vaccination, Honorable Chair, per barangay. So barangays are still have a chance to get the 80% coverage of their first booster vaccination, Honorable Chair.
Thank you, Honorable. What are the possible incentive that was granted by the different barangay?
Yeah, the most important, Honorable Chair, is to achieve the target percentage requirement of 80%, since that requirement is being committed by our beloved governor to our president, that Osamis or the Misamis Occidental will reach or will achieve the 80% first booster vaccination, Honorable Chair. So in our participation, being the barangay belong to the Misamis Occidental and the barangays belong to the city. So we are also on our part to be aggressive for us to contribute, no? Contribute the entire province of reaching the 80% first booster vaccination, Honorable Chair. So our Punong barangays now is, of course, having their more specific and more strategic way of conducting or visiting or any move of our Punong barangays just to achieve the 80%, Honorable Chair.
It is understood that the barangay officials are having a strong campaign for this vaccination program in order to reach the 80%.
Yes, Honorable Chair.
And what are some of the incentive that they are trying to give to the benefit residents?
Other barangays, Honorable Chair, have added
a 5 kilos rice or whatever.
Another 5 kilos rice. So okay. In addition to our existing incentive by the LGU.
On top of what was given by the LGU.
Yeah, on top of the.
So the respective barangays also giving their own.
There are only some, Honorable Chair, since
not
the,
all.
They did not have their allocation of certain COVID assistance budget, Honorable Chair, program. They did not. Make any budget for that purpose, Honorable Chair. So only some, there are only few barangays have done the incentive or the ayuda support, Honorable Chair, for those who decided to who have their vaccination, Honorable Chair, for first booster.
Okay. So how many, as of this time, how many percent that we were able to reach?
Usamis, as of yesterday, Honorable Chair, I tried to check my... Usamis City have already reached the... We are now on...
So far, ang
63%, Honorable Chair.
Yeah, I believe that so far, ang Usami City has the highest percentage all over
yes,
the region. We were able to reach, I think, pila na?
63.22% as of yesterday, Honorable Chair.
Okay.
So
we are trying to hit the target of 80%.
Not yet, Honorable Chair. But we... That's why barangays is also compelled to move any
conduct strong campaign
to conduct more no monang para sa 80% Honorable Chair since Usamis is only 63 so almost to 80% Honorable Chair.
Okay, thank you. Is there any remarks? Yes, Honorable Ko.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I just want to clarify with the ABC Vice Chairman regarding the 63% achieved percentage of Usami City citizens that are vaccinated. So we are talking about the first booster.
First booster only, yes, Honorable.
That is 63%. 63 point something percent.
63.
And the requirement in the barangays are up to complete dosage lang man, no?
No.
Not including the booster.
First booster. Barangays is
booster.
Also...
So the barangays are trying to hit...
80%
for
the first booster.
For all those who should have the first booster.
Yes.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Yes.
Thank you, Honorable Ko, for your manifestation. Any other remarks? From the former barangay officials of this August body, yes, from Malaubang, Anan. Okay, any other comments? What about, yes, Honorable Bation, you may have some comments or remarks. Wala. How was your IP? Are they aggressive now to have some, to avail of this program, vaccination? Kumusta mga ito mga IPs?
Madam Chair, ang update is katurang second and first boost second first and second vaccine but ang booster nila is murag sa pag-meeting na mo last time wala pa gid sila nakapa-booster ang uban but ang uban ang manasad.
Okay, so at least they have availed of the first and second vaccination, ang booster may wala pa. Okay. Can you conduct a strong campaign for your IPs to avail of this boostering program? In the way that's there for their own good, no? What about the young people? May we hear from Honorable Ochavillo?
One TV special, 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 special report.